All living things absorb very little amount of radioactive carbon-14 during their lifespan. So do we all emit radiation? Yes. Means we have superpowers? No. With the interruption of death, the process of amassing radioactive carbon goes on halt forever. But the one thing that does not die in a dead matter is radioactive carbon. The half-life span of radioactive carbon is 5,730 years, which means, if we have 1 kilogram of radioactive carbon today, so after a span of 5,730 years, only half of it will be remaining. And, because radioactive decay follows exponential function, so it will take around 10 half-life cycles for the whole carbon-14 to disappear, except 0.1 of itself. And in years, these 10 life cycles are around 50 to 55,000 years. Okay, that is a lot of repetition of the word year. In a nutshell, it means, carbon-14 takes 5,730 years to reduce into half. The whole cycle of radioactive carbon starts when the cosmic ray interacts with the nitrogen in the atmosphere. The produced radioactive carbon then combines with the oxygen and produces radioactive carbon dioxide, which is consumed by plants during the process of photosynthesis. And then different parts of plants are consumed by different animals. And these animals are consumed by other animals, as depicted in food chain. This process tells how and why the radioactive carbon traces are found in the living matter. But how much radioactive carbon an organism accumulates in its lifespan? The interesting thing is that the number is the same for everyone. If at present we measure the amount of radioactive carbon in our body, or in any other living organism, for example, if we test carbon-14 presence in a mouse, and in a mouse killer, means a cat, the abundance of radioactive carbon in both the organisms will be equal to each other. And not only that, this amount is also equal to the radioactive carbon present in the atmosphere. Again, in a nutshell, as Euclidean theorem says, if A is equal to B, B is equal to C, means A is also equal to C. In the case of marine organisms, the carbon level is the same as the amount of carbon-14 present in the ocean. In a dead organic matter, radioactive carbon starts decomposing back into nitrogen over time. It is a type of beta decay. So it can be said that the dead body of any organism keeps radiating electrons, or we can say radiation. As we have discussed earlier, one half decomposing cycle of carbon-14 takes 5,730 years. Well, to be exact, the next 10 half cycles would take around 57,000 years to complete. So, when it comes to how far back carbon-14 dating can be used, the answer is around 50,000 years to 55,000 years. So this method gives us an approximate number that how old an organism can be. This process revolutionized the field of archaeology and paleontology. Then how do we trace back dinosaur bones, which are more than 60 million years old? Well, that is a topic for another quick video. And there we will also see the solution of the problem associated with carbon dating. So, let's see the problem with radioactive carbon dating. In the years around 1950s and 60s, when scientists were calculating the age of different samples, they found a difference in the actual age by a margin of around 40 years. When scientists looked more closely to find the reason for this margin difference, they looked back at their calculations, but there was no mistake in them. Then, they used a tree layer which acts as a natural calendar. Trees' layers are stacked over each other, and each layer has different accumulation of carbon in it, which depends on the surrounding. They saw that the tree layers had different concentrations of radioactive carbon, rather than uniform. This was due to exposure to external radioactivity. The major source of external radioactive radiation is considered the number of nuclear tests conducted during different years around 50s and 60s. Means to say that the age predicted after measuring the amount of radioactive carbon in a dead matter is only 95% correct. But science is a field of precision, and this margin of 40 years is a big value. To give the exact number, scientists came up with other techniques, which we will discuss in the quick future videos. So we can really say that carbon is actually a special element. Carbon-12 amazing arrangement produces living mass, and carbon-14, the radioactive form, tells us the age of those objects. This was a quick explanation of carbon dating. Make sure you subscribe and turn that notification bell on, and do not forget to share your thoughts in the comment section.